all, I want to just say thank you to you and Texas and all that you've done to really protect the security of the United States. Thank you for the update this morning, for giving us the opportunity to do the aerial view, to really understand the challenges that the terrain presents, to get a chance to see the buoys and the sea wires and just all of the efforts that are being put in place to secure this country. Texas has been ground zero for over 2 years because the Biden created catastrophe that we see at the southern border, whether it's national security, public safety, or just an assault on our democracy. You have been front and center through all of that. And because they have, on day one, this administration has reversed policies that protect the sovereignty of this country and the citizens, and ultimately have made every state a border state, certainly not to the extent that Texas is experiencing. But let me tell you, Iowa is located at the intersection of two major interstates, and it is a pathway for the Mexican cartel and for human traffickers to take to go from Mexico to the Midwest. Since 2020, we have seen a 500% increase in the amount of fentanyl that has been seized. We've seen a 100% increase in meth, and we have seen drug-related deaths increase by 35%. Earlier this year, in 90 days from March to May, and I want to get these statistics because I don't want to get them wrong, the DPS actually seized 27,500 fentanyl tablets, 330 pounds of meth, and 72 pounds of cocaine. Again, I know that's nothing compared to what you're seeing here, but the bulk of those seizures can be tied directly to Mexico and the cartel, and we're 1,000 miles away from Eagle Pass. I want to say before I turn it back over, just as the chair of the Republican Governors Association, I want to thank the 16 Republican governors that stepped up to do the job that the Biden administration has failed to do. We have over 1,600 National Guard soldiers that have committed to help you, 330 and counting law enforcement that have stepped up. I'm proud to say that Iowa has 109 National Guard soldiers on the ground today. I want to thank my Adjutant General from Iowa, General Osborne. I want to thank him for his service and his leadership. And again, thank the Republican governors in all the states, as you indicated, for stepping in and doing what the Biden administration should be doing. The fact that the states are protecting the southern border is an assault on the Constitution and the American people. And it is time for this president to step up, way past time, and do his job.
Thank you, Governor.